Good morning. I am very pleased to be here with Vice President Garzon of Colombia on his first visit to Washington as Vice President. Before discussing the important matters that were part of our meeting, I would like to say something about the unfolding events in Egypt. We continue to monitor the situation very closely. We are deeply concerned about the use of violence by Egyptian police and security forces against protesters. And we call on the Egyptian government to do everything in its power to restrain the security forces. At the same time, protesters should also refrain from violence and express themselves peacefully. As we have repeatedly said, we support the universal human rights of the Egyptian people, including the right to freedom of expression, of association, and of assembly. We urge the Egyptian authorities to allow peaceful protests and to reverse the unprecedented steps it has taken to cut off communications. These protests underscore that there are deep grievances within Egyptian society, and the Egyptian government needs to understand that violence will not make these grievances go away. As President Obama said yesterday, reform is absolutely critical to the well-being of Egypt. Egypt has long been an important partner of the United States on a range of regional issues. As a partner, we strongly believe that the Egyptian government needs to engage immediately with the Egyptian people in implementing needed economic, political, and social reforms. We continue to raise with the Egyptian government, as we do with other governments in the region, the imperative for reform and greater openness and participation to provide a better future for all. We want to partner with the Egyptian people and their government to realize their aspirations to live in a democratic society that respects basic human rights. When I was recently in the region, I met with a wide range of civil society groups, and I heard from them about ideas they have that would improve their countries. The people of the Middle East, like people everywhere, are seeking a chance to contribute and to have a role in the decisions that will shape their lives. As I said in Doha, leaders need to respond to these aspirations and to help build that better future for all. They need to view civil society as their partner, not as a threat. Now, there is a great deal of concern also in our government, Mr. Vice President, about the mining disaster that killed 21 miners in Colombia. And we will have our translator translate these remarks about Colombia as we go along. I know that President Santos cut short his stay at the World Economic Forum to join the families of these victims. And I would like the people of Colombia to know they are in the thoughts and prayers of all Americans, not just for the mining tragedy, but for the terrible flooding that in the past 2 months has claimed more than 300 lives, affected more than 2 million people, and incurred billions of dollars in reconstruction and cleanup costs.
Es un placer estar aquí con el vicepresidente Garzón en esta su primera visita a Washington como vicepresidente. Quiero darle la bienvenida luego de un paréntesis. Comenzamos con la bienvenida quiero expresar mi pésame al pueblo de Colombia por el desastre minero que cercenó las vidas de 21 mineros. Sé que el presidente Santos tuvo que acortar su visita al Foro Económico Mundial para unirse a las familias de las víctimas y quiero también que el pueblo de Colombia sepa que todos ellos están en nuestros pensamientos y en nuestras oraciones, no solamente por esta tragedia, sino también por las inundaciones que han devastado al país en los últimos dos meses y han dejado a más de 300 muertos, afectando a más de 2 millones de personas y con un costo de reconstrucción de miles de millones de dólares.
The Vice President and I had a very productive, wide-ranging discussion on many important issues, and we reaffirmed the resilient, enduring partnership and friendship between our peoples.
El vicepresidente y yo acabamos de celebrar una discusión muy productiva sobre muchos temas importantísimos en la cual reafirmamos la asociación permanente y fuerte que une la larga historia entre nuestros pueblos.
We share common values and a respect for democratic governance, the rule of law, and self-determination.
Compartimos valores comunes y un respeto por el gobierno democrático, el Estado de Derecho y la autodeterminación.
And the United States has stood with Colombia for more than a decade as they take on security challenges.
Los Estados Unidos ha estado de pie unido al pueblo colombiano hace más de un decenio en su lucha para asegurar su seguridad.
We've made considerable progress together, but we have more work to do on security and other issues.
Hemos logrado grandes progresos juntos, pero todavía tenemos más trabajo que hacer sobre temas de seguridad y otros.
That is why we are hosting the second round of the U.S.-Colombia High-Level Partnership Dialogue in March, where we will cover so many of these issues.
Es por eso que vamos a auspiciar la segunda vuelta de discusión del diálogo de alto nivel entre Colombia y los Estados Unidos en marzo.
We are committed to a very broad discussion of issues from sustainable energy to human rights.
Estamos dedicados a hablar sobre todo una amplia gama de temas que van desde la energía sustentable a los derechos humanos.
And as President Obama said in his State of the Union address, we are committed to a successful conclusion and ratification of the U.S.-Colombia Trade Agreement.
Y como dijo el presidente Obama en su discurso ante el país entero esta semana, estamos dedicados a lograr una conclusión y ratificación exitosas del acuerdo de libre comercio entre Colombia y los Estados Unidos.
And I look forward to working with the Vice President and members of the Colombian government to bring that result about.
Y anticipo con gran alegría seguir trabajando con el vicepresidente y con el gobierno de Colombia para lograr eso.
I also commended the Vice President and the Santos administration for the progress that is being made on resolving long-term disputes having to do with displaced people in the country and reaching out to civil society to add their voices to a national conversation about human rights and labor rights.
Y también felicité al vicepresidente Garzón y al gobierno del presidente Santos por los logros que han logrado en ayudar a los que han perdido sus hogares y sus tierras y también para alcanzar a grupos de la sociedad civil para agregar su voz a la conversación nacional sobre derechos humanos y derechos laborales.
And I want to thank Colombia for their assistance to other countries in the fight against drug traffickers and criminal organizations.
Y quiero darle las gracias también a Colombia por la ayuda que le han prestado a otros países en combatir a los narcotraficantes y al crimen organizado.
Their assistance to the people of Haiti and of Afghanistan And in so many ways, the leadership that Colombia is showing in helping to solve difficult issues.
También su trabajo en Haití, su trabajo en Afganistán y el liderazgo que han demostrado en tantos temas para ayudar a solucionar los problemas mundiales.
And we look forward to continuing and close cooperation, Mr. Vice President.
Será una gran alegría para nosotros, señor vicepresidente, seguir trabajando con ustedes en estrecha cooperación.
Muchas gracias, señora Hillary Clinton, secretaria de Estado de los Estados Unidos.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Hillary Clinton, Secretary of State of the United States.
Expresarle a nombre del gobierno de Colombia y en especial del presidente Juan Manuel Santos Calderón nuestros agradecimientos a usted y al presidente Obama por las manifestaciones de solidaridad con el pueblo de Colombia con motivo de los desastres de la ola invernal y también con motivo de la tragedia que ha costado la vida a 21 mineros y ha dejado heridos a varios mineros en la zona de Sardinata en Santander.
I want to say on behalf of the government of Colombia and very especially on behalf of President Santos, I would like to express our thanks to you, Mrs. Clinton, and to President Obama for the solidarity of your government and your people to the people of Colombia on the occasion of the recent floods and in particular the recent mining tragedy which has cost 21 lives, has left several injured in the area of Santander in our country.
En el diálogo que hemos tenido con la Secretaría de Estado, hemos coincidido en trabajar por la defensa de valores de la democracia, entre ellos la política de promoción y respeto integral de los derechos humanos, incluyendo los derechos laborales, ambientales, los derechos de pueblos indígenas, afrodescendientes y de las mujeres.
And in our broad-ranging discussions today, we have agreed, among other things, to work together to defend the fundamental rights of humankind, the human rights that affect all of us, in particular, labor groups, indigenous groups, women's groups, and others.
Igualmente, seguir trabajando y cooperando con todos los países en contra de la criminalidad organizada, incluyendo delitos transnacionales como el narcotráfico, que son contrarios a las instituciones democráticas y a la vida democrática de cualquier país.
And we have also agreed to continue to work and cooperate with all countries to combat organized crime, in particular transnational crime, which includes drug trafficking, which attacks our democracies.
En el diálogo valoramos altamente la voluntad política del gobierno de los Estados Unidos en cabeza del presidente Obama, de la señora Hillary Clinton, en torno a encontrar todos los caminos que nos permitan la aprobación del Tratado de Libre Comercio entre Estados Unidos y Colombia, a partir de que beneficia al gobierno y al pueblo de los Estados Unidos y beneficia al gobierno y al pueblo de Colombia.
In our dialogue, we have expressed our gratefulness for the political will of the United States government, in particular President Obama and Secretary Clinton, to find all paths necessary to achieve ratification of the free trade agreement between Colombia and the United States. It is an agreement that helps the people and the government of Colombia, and it also helps the people and government of the United States.
E igualmente valoramos enormemente la disposición del gobierno de los Estados Unidos, del Congreso de los Estados Unidos, para aprobar las preferencias arancelarias de Colombia y otros países de la región andina. Y en el caso particular de Colombia, como un mensaje de solidaridad con el pueblo de Colombia en momentos en que estamos empeñados en la reconstrucción del país como consecuencia de toda la ola invernal.
And we also greatly appreciate the willingness of the U.S. government and the U.S. Congress to extend the Andean Trade Preferences Act, not just to the region, but to Colombia in particular. This is a sign of great solidarity at a time when we are busy with the reconstruction of our country after the devastating floods.
Igualmente hemos coincidido en redoblar todos los esfuerzos bajo el liderazgo de la señora Hillary Clinton, del presidente Juan Manuel Santos Calderón, en todo el proceso de solidaridad, de reconstrucción de Haití y también de acompañamiento para que en Haití, el pueblo de Haití libre y soberanamente se puedan dar sus propios gobernantes.
And we also agreed to redouble our joint efforts along with Secretary Clinton and President Santos Calderón regarding Haiti, to support the people of Haiti in their quest to elect freely and fairly their own leaders.
Y hemos quedado en consolidar todo este diálogo de alto nivel que bajo el liderazgo de la señora Hillary Clinton hemos emprendido desde el año pasado entre Estados Unidos y Colombia, siempre con la mira de fortalecer programas comunes, la democracia y los derechos humanos, los temas de las nuevas tecnologías, los temas energéticos, y hoy hemos considerado que los temas ambientales también hagan parte de la agenda de este diálogo de alto nivel.
And we will consolidate our high-level dialogue, a dialogue that we began last year between the United States and Colombia. This has been headed by Secretary Clinton. We will be strengthening our programs, to discuss issues ranging from all kinds of progress in democracy, human rights, new technologies, energy, and also one that we have added after our dialogue today, the environment.
Y en nombre del gobierno de Colombia, el presidente Juan Manuel Santos Calderón, del pueblo de Colombia, agradezco enormemente el reconocimiento a los avances de Colombia como país en progreso, de nuestros esfuerzos por consolidar a Colombia como un Estado moderno y de los esfuerzos que hoy estamos haciendo en favor de las víctimas de la violencia y en la lucha contra la corrupción, contra la criminalidad organizada y contra la impunidad y por la vigencia y respeto pleno de los derechos humanos, incluyendo los derechos laborales y ambientales en nuestro país. Muchas gracias, señora secretaria.
And on behalf of the government of Colombia, President Santos, and the people of Colombia, I want to thank you very much for recognizing the progress that Colombia has made as a developing country to consolidate itself as a modern state in combating corruption, violence, and impunity, and in upholding human rights.
First question, the Associated Press.
Yes, Madam Secretary. Excuse me, I have two rather direct questions to ask you about Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
The first, is President Mubarak finished? The second, are you at this point condemning the violent crackdown against protesters?
Well, I think we have been answering those concerns for quite some time. And as President Obama said yesterday very clearly, and as I said in Doha, it is absolutely vital for Egypt to embrace reform, to ensure not just its long-term stability, but also the progress and prosperity that its people richly deserve. Now, Egypt has been a strong partner of the United States on a range of regional and strategic interests. And as a partner, we believe strongly and have expressed this consistently that the Egyptian government needs to engage with the Egyptian people in implementing needed political, economic, and social reforms. We have consistently raised this with the Egyptian government over many years. We also have raised it with other governments in the region. And there is a constant concern about the need for greater openness, greater participation on the part of the people, particularly young people, which is something I was very clear about in Doha. And we want to continue to partner with the Egyptian government and the Egyptian people. Now, what will eventually happen in Egypt is up to Egyptians. But it is important for us to make very clear that as a partner of Egypt, we are urging that there be a restraint on the part of the security forces, there not be a rush to impose very strict measures that would be violent, and that there be a dialogue between the government and the people of Egypt. At the same time, we also would urge the protesters to engage in peaceful protest, which they have every right to do, and the deep grievances that they are raising deserve to be addressed. But the real question we're focused on is how can we support a better future for the people of Egypt that, you know, responds to their aspirations. And as I've said before, and as the president has also said, the Egyptian government has a real opportunity in the face of this very clear demonstration of opposition to begin a process that will truly respond to the aspirations of the people of Egypt. We think that moment needs to be seized, and we are hoping that it is.
And Simone?
Madam Secretary, two points. The first one is Vice President Garzon asked 2 days ago the Obama administration to send this year to Congress the free trade agreement. With all due respect, is the EU Obama administration going to do that, yes or no?
Yes.
This year?
Yes.
Okay.
When we have an agreement, there are still negotiations that are taking place. And as the Vice President and I discussed, when we have an agreed upon text, we will, as quickly as possible, send it to the Congress. It is not yet in the form of agreement that we have been discussing with our Colombian counterparts. They know what we need to do in order to get a successful outcome. We don't want to send an agreement just for the sake of sending an agreement. We want to send an agreement and get it passed.
So you want to change the agreement?
We are discussing about some clarifications and some concerns that we know will have to be addressed in the Congress. I mean, I'm just being very clear with you. We want to pass the agreement. In order to pass the agreement, we have to be able to make the case to the Congress. And that is what I am intent upon doing. Excuse me, this gentleman has the microphone.
No, I have a second question. In Colombia, some sector of the public opinion. Yes.
Sí, la pregunta era, el vicepresidente Garzón le ha pedido que puedan, que manden el acuerdo de libre comercio este año al Congreso. ¿Cuándo se va a hacer? La respuesta de la secretaria es cuando tengamos un acuerdo que logre todas las aclaraciones y trate todas las preocupaciones que hemos discutido para que no tengamos ningún problema en el Congreso para su aprobación.
Yo quiero destacar lo fundamental.
Y es, what's really important and basic here.
Y es la gran voluntad política del presidente Obama, de la secretaria de Estado Hillary Clinton, del gobierno de los Estados Unidos y también de parlamentarios demócratas y republicanos de avanzar conjuntamente con el gobierno de Colombia lo más pronto posible en la aprobación del Tratado de Libre Comercio.
I want to point out the great political will of President Obama, the Secretary of State, and of the U.S. government and members of Congress from both sides of the aisle to move as soon as possible to achieve ratification of this agreement.
Yo creo que eso es lo más importante.
I think that's the most important thing.
And we agree, and that's why we want to proceed as quickly and effectively to guarantee success as possible.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Can we make a poll?